Knobbox Dance presents.
But this idea of thinking that dance is not necessarily a visual art form, but other senses are being engaged. And I think that then moves to many of the aspects, whether that's in the process or in the final product in relation to social media, or, you know, how can we engage these other senses? And I think certainly for dance, where it's really about the body in space, but also as the spectator, engaging with all the senses, not only what we see, but what we feel, what we listen to. This thing of through repetition, the work comes anew again. And through repetition, only through repetition, will I understand something again about what the work is, or even speaking back to what I'm working in on at the moment. So that it's not, you could say once a performance is, in my case, once a performance has its premiere, the piece is more or less done, in the sense that it doesn't change maybe in its writing. Like, I don't start to say, okay, I'm going to end it differently, or I'm going to change these two parts like that. It is more or less, I think it would be very small things that would change, if anything at all. Mm. But nevertheless, the idea of repeating them again is really what gives me the reflection of what the work is about. And one thing is what has happened during the creation process up until that moment, when the work is then repeated in front of audiences, and what each of these situations feeds back to the work. So for me, the repetition is not only about visibility, showing the works more to more people, but it is also my experience of being in the work again in order to continue being in that process of, I think when it's just out in social media, it lacks a bit of context. So for instance, if you were to ask me about the recording of the last performance, I could give that to you, and you, there will be another context for wanting to watch it. And I think that's also okay. It's not about making into a fetish of, no recording or something like that. It's more a practical tool. So when someone is interested in that, I'm totally fine to share it, but I don't have the need to, that it's constantly available or out there outside of a context. In that sense, I think when I started making my own work, it was not a conscious choice at that time. It's something that I realized with time, is that there was a lot of interest in traces in different forms, whether that's publications, drawings, that takes a certain shape and maybe is put on paper later. So there's been an interest in how, what are traces from these performances or other kinds of byproducts around it, which is also part of this reflexive process of what the work is and so on. So video is one way of capturing something, and in a sense a quite straightforward media, you could say. But yeah, in some cases, for example, when the work is, as I say, it's not so visual, you would need to know that the work is also about another relationship to how we experience listening. Other senses are being involved than seeing. So how to introduce that, even when you are looking at the work on video. For me, the way of saying no is somehow not about, I think it's a very constructive no that I would be interested in. And I'm thinking then about the the conventions of the box. I'm thinking of the theater. I'm not thinking of box as categories.
Right.
But so you have to put me on another track if that's what you want me to.
No. There's no right or wrong answer. We have to hear your ideas.
So I'm really thinking of the box as the theater, and I think since there's been, you know, we have deconstructed the theater already, so that's not something we need to, I feel, invest into. But maybe it's about how do we construct it? How do we build new imaginations? How do we build new ways of being there? How do we, you know, construct other narratives or other ways of being in and building in that space? So the, you know, when someone will say, you know, because in my work, a lot of the time the space is empty, and you could say it's deconstructing the theater because there is nothing there. And I would say it's not deconstructing the theater. The space is empty when I come. I'm not taking anything away, but it's maybe more about what I bring in is very small. So I'm trying to tune into giving attention to these things or looking at the things in another way, and from there constructing something.
Thanks for taking your time to tune into Dance Behind the Screen, a bi-monthly interview series where we go behind the screen to question process, product, and social media. Be sure to follow us on social media at KNOW Box Dance. See you next time, and don't forget to say no to the box.